Hi everybody. Hi everybody. In last videos we discussed about packing fraction of simple cube and packing fraction of BCC. Packing fraction of simple cube and packing fraction of BCC. See here. In this video we are going to learn about packing fraction of FCC or CCP. What is that? Packing fraction we studied. Packing fraction. That is for simple cubic one, for BCC, for FCC. Otherwise also called as CCP. These two we discussed in the last videos. You can observe. You can watch this. You can watch the previous videos. How much we got for this one? Packing fraction is 52.3% we got. Here also 68% we got. Now we are going to find out the packing fraction of water. Packing fraction of what? FCC. Generally packing fraction, what is the formula? What we studied? Total volume. Total volume. What is that? Occupied by atoms. Where? In unit cell. By, what is that? Volume of unit cell. What do we know? Volume of the unit cell always constant. That is generally edge length will be A, so that A into A, that will be A cube. So volume occupied by the atoms in the unit cell only required. For simple cube unit cell we studied. For BCC, we studied. Now we are going to study about FCC. So, we are going to find out the packing fraction of FCC means what we need R and A relation. After that, effective number of atoms in FCC. After that, this packing fraction formula you have to apply. Then you will get the packing fraction of FCC. So now we will go to the lecture. Packing efficiency, otherwise packing fraction in FCC or CCP unit cell. This is FCC. Face center means, what is the meaning? All the corners occupied by the spheres, and each face, center of the face also atoms are there. So all the six faces can occupied by the spheres, and all the corners also can be occupied by the spheres. Now what do you want? You need a relation between R and A. As we discussed, we need a relation between R and A. After that, number of atoms. After that, formula apply. So what I am going to find out? A. I have to observe only this one. Where I have to observe only one face. Any face you can observe. This face I will observe. While observing this face, see, there is a face diagonal. I will mark here. It is a face diagonal. It is a face diagonal. In this face diagonal, how many atoms are there? In this here, part of one atom is there. What is this? Here, part of one atom is there. This is the part. And here, part of one atom is there. So, this is the face diagonal. This is the face diagonal. This is equals to radius of all these spheres. This is only 1 R. What is 1 R? This part you are going to observe means, see, this part you are going to observe means, I am denoting with color. The corner sphere radius is, this is the corner sphere radius. After that, central sphere, full complete sphere is there. So complete diameter is there. That means 2 radius. And finally, here what is there? Finally, one more corner sphere. This is the R. While observing, what is there? R is here. Here full diameter R and R. So that 2R, here R is there. This completely becomes completely equals to the diagonal of the face. That is what? Face diagonal. So what is the length of the phase diagonal? See, this is root 2a, the given. How it is coming? Observe this. Triangle ABC is a, here 90 degrees there. It is a triangle. The angle is 90. What you can observe in a in this angle, Pythagoras theorem you are applying is what is that? Diagonal AC square. Diagonal AC square is equal to side square plus side square. What is one side? AB square plus what is other side? BC square. That's what they are writing. AC square. This one I want to find out. This is my question mark. Here AB square plus BC square. AB means what is that? A. In this place A you are going to write. BC means what is that in this place? A you are also A square. AC unit means you are going to make a square root. What you are going to get? A square plus A square. 2A square. Square root you are getting means root 2A. Square root you are going to get means root 2A you can get. This is what the calculation. Based on the calculation, the length of the face diagonal is root 2A. That is equal to sum of the all the radius. So all the R, first one and this two, R plus R, and last one will be R. All this combined giving 4R. This 4R is equal to length of the body diagonal. So that R value will be A root 2 by 4. Okay. Then come further. Volume of the sphere with radius R is. Volume of the sphere, all this, you are observing spheres, every sphere having a same radius only. Same atoms are there, so that radius also will be same. How to find out the volume of that, volume of the sphere, one sphere, spherical shape, what is this formula? 4/3 pi r cube. So 4/3 pi r cube, in the place of r, root 2a by 4. Why? Already r value is equal to root 2a by 4. This root 2a by 4 you are going to substitute here, root 2a by 4 here, in this 4/3 pi r cube, in the place of r you are going to substitute this one, r value, r is equal to root 2a by 4 substituted, means you are going to get this one. Calculation finished, this much coming. This is the volume of the sphere. Then total number of spheres belongs to the single FCC unit cell. Total number of spheres in FCC is 4. Already we calculated in FCC. How to calculate? In FCC how to calculate? In FCC all the corner atoms are there. See here. In FCC all the corners are there. How many corners are there? 8 corners are there. From each corner, what is the contribution? What is the contribution from the each corner? 1/8 part of the sphere. Like that, 8 corners are there. From each corner sphere, 1/8 part is coming. Both are cancelled, means effective number of atoms from the corner is 1. Okay, next, this is from the corners, no? Then from faces. How many faces are there? 6 faces are there. So, each sphere contributes to the unit cell. What is the contribution of each sphere to the unit cell? Half part only. Complete sphere not belongs to this unit cell. Half part of the sphere belongs to this sphere. Remaining half will be other. Half part of the sphere belongs to this unit cell. Other half part of the units, half part of the sphere belongs to other unit cell. Here also, half part of the sphere belongs to this unit cell. Remaining half is present in other cube, other unit cell. So that 1/2 is the contribution of each sphere which is located at the face center. Like that, how many faces are there? 6 faces are there. 6 into 1/2, 3. From corners, effective number of atoms is 1. From the faces, effective number of atoms is 3. Overall, in a face center cubic cell, effective number of atoms are 4. That is what 4 are there. So that they said total number of spheres belongs to the unit, a single FCC is 4. Effectively 4 atoms are there, 4 spheres are there. What is the volume of one sphere? What is the volume of one sphere? This is the value. 4 into this value. Then this is the volume occupied by all the 4 spheres in FCC. But FCC is 1 cube, no? So 1 cube means what is the volume of the cube? A cube. What is our formula? Already we studied. Formula means total volume occupied by the atoms in the unit cell. Total volume occupied by the atoms in the unit cell by volume of the unit cell. Total volume occupied by means, what is that? 4 atoms are there into volume of each sphere by volume of the unit cell A cube. That's what here. This is the 4 into this volume of each sphere. This much value coming. This value you are going to keep here. It is A cube is the volume of the cube. Volume of the cube into 100. You are going to do the calculation is 74% will come. Finally, how can you conclude? In this one, 74% is coming. In CCP or FCC, the packing fraction is 74 and empty space is 26. How can you get empty space? I told overall 100 is there. In that 100, 74 is packed with the spheres. And remaining, how much remaining? 26 is the empty space, otherwise wide space. In the examination, they can ask the questions in terms of packing fraction, packing efficiency, otherwise in terms of empty space, otherwise void percentage. For neat and all, they can ask in this manner so that you have to remember these numbers. How can you remember? For a simple cube packing fraction, they are asking means 52.3%. For BCC, they are asking means 68% is the packing fraction. Now, for FCC or CCP, they are asking means 74 is the packing fraction. They are asking a void percent means 100 minus this one, 100 minus this one, 100 minus this one. That is a different question. They are asking empty space, otherwise void space means you have to subtract the packing fraction from the 100. Finally, small concept is there. This is belongs to ionic compounds. This is the radius ratio. In some books, you can also study as a limiting value. You can also study as a limiting value. Otherwise, sometimes you can study as a limiting radius. Some books also you can study as a limiting radius. Otherwise, limiting value. Anyway, this is observed in the ionic compounds. Ionic compounds, what is there? Cations are there, anions are there. Generally, anions are bigger in size, cations are smaller in size. By knowing the radius of, this is the center, no? Radius of anion, this is the anion means, by knowing the radius of anion, that is Ra minus, by knowing the radius of cation, that is Rc plus, these two values you know means, you are going to find the limiting radius, otherwise radius ratio, radius of cation. There is a radius of cation by radius of anion. These two you are writing, one value will come. That value is given in the form of a ranges here, ranges. This you have to remember. No alternate for everybody. Remember this order. If this value, whatever the value you are getting here, that is in this range means, then the coordination number will be 3 and the structure will be trigonal planar, that is B2O3 example. If that radius ratio is in between 0.225 to 0.414, that the coordination number will be 4. And that structure will be tetrahedral structure, ZNS is that one. Anyway, similar way, the radius of cation to radius of anion will be 0.414 to 0.732. At the time, the coordination number is 6. Then we can say that void or that structure will be octahedral, and that example will be NaCl. Similar way, the radius ratio will be in between 0.732 to 1. At the time, that coordination number is 8 cubic. How questions can come in the examination? They will give the R plus value. What is that? They will give the R plus value. They will give the R minus value. Radius of cation, radius of anion, they will give. Then what is the coordination number of the structure? What you have to find out? R plus by R minus. Then value will come. That value you have to observe. That is present. That is belongs to which range out of this 4? Based on the range only you have to choose the coordination number in the options. This is also important for the NEET examination. What is important here is numbers are important. How to remember means you have to practice. Many times you are practicing, automatically you can remember this thing. So this is what our study. Thank you.